URA has extended the grace period of 2 days for the tax penalty waiver on the affected traders as per the presidential directive. Traders have therefore been urged to take advantage of this extension so as to benefit from the tax waiver penalty that was imposed on them after failing to comply. According to Robert Kalumba, URA's Public and Corporate Affairs Manager, traders were given a period of 1 week to reconcile with Uganda Revenue Authority, but because of large numbers of traders spending this service, URA has given this extension. Kalumba says URA has made necessary efforts to sensitize the traders about electronic fiscal receipting and invoicing solution, IFRIS, as was directed by the president. During a meeting with the traders on July 7th at Kololo Independence Grounds, President Museveni directed that traders who had incurred tax penalties as a result of non-compliance get a waiver by URA and that they get more sensitization of IFRIS. Old Kampala police have arrested Opanya Darius and Azabo Samuel in connection with an aggravated torture video circulating on social media. It is alleged that on February 3, 2024, the two suspects had a misunderstanding with Chitoke Isaac, an 18-year-old, and assaulted him using a long stick while confining him with building iron bars atop a building they were guarding along Nachivubo in Kampala City, which was under construction. The video began circulating on social media last week, prompting the police to open a general inquiry file. After identifying the suspects, the police stressed and apprehended them. The victim has been issued a police form 3 for a medical checkup. Would like to clarify that, contrary to some reports on social media, the individual seen torturing the victim in the video is not a police officer. He is a local guard identified as Opanya Darius, whom the victim refers to as Commander Ivan in the video. The other suspect, Samuel, is believed to have recorded the video. The two suspects have confessed to the actions portrayed in the video and have been charged with aggravated torture. India's Hindu nationalist Prime Minister Narendra Modi claimed election victory for his party and its allies on Tuesday, but the opposition said they had punished the ruling party to confound predictions and reduce their parliamentary majority. Commentators and exit polls had projected an overwhelming victory for Modi, whose campaign wooed the Hindu majority to the worry of the country's 200 million plus Muslim community, deepening concerns over minority rights. But for the first time in a decade, Modi's BJP party failed to secure an overall majority of its own. Figures from the Election Commission showed, meaning it would need to rely on its alliance partners. India has placed its faith in the ruling coalition for a third consecutive time. Modi wrote on social media platform X, referring to the BJP and its allies. With nearly 99% of the votes counted, the BJP's vote share at 36.7% was marginally lower than it was in the last polls in 2019. Celebrations had already begun at the headquarters of Modi's BJP before the full announcement of results. But the mood at the Congress headquarters in New Delhi was also one of jubilation.